So today we are cleaning off the hull so we can do about the 500th round of fairing.
Like the
100th round of fairing.
I want to say, like, including the first coats, we're probably up to like 6 rounds, 7 rounds on certain areas. I mean, I should really button up those areas though.
I hope so.
There shouldn't be a lot up on the hull.
So we're just going to go around, acetone everything.
Everywhere it needs to be hit. I'm not acetoning everything, just where it needs to be hit.
Everything that needs to be hit, yeah. With fairing compound. And then fairing.
Yeah.
Any final words?
All right, I'm getting yelled at for time lapsing, so. Use some good old acetone. And just a old cut up t-shirt. And yeah, definitely save your old t-shirts, because
you're gonna need them.
Yeah, you're gonna need them. Cut them up, make rags. They make wonderful rags, you know. Just kind of wiping down everything we have to re-hit with bearing compound. Yeah. I marked a bunch of spots last time I sanded. You can like feel them. You can feel like the little ridge.
Yeah, but then I have the strake over here that I haven't even put anything on yet. It's still bare glass. So it's kind of funny how. You know, gotta stop jumping around at this point and just kind of focus. Alright, you guys get the idea. Lots of washing, lots of acetone. Change your rags every once in a while because they get dirty. And yeah, kind of prep everything and get ready to go for another coat.
So one thing I noticed while I was laying down the fairing compound on top of the motor wells was when I would press fairing compound into the serrations, it almost left like air pockets underneath. But it could have just been my method. I ended up going over it a few times and it looked like I got all of the air pockets out of it. So if anyone has any suggestions on how to do this better, or if they have a different kind of method while doing the serrations, you should let us know below in the comments. So if you're going to learn anything during boat building, it's how to improvise. In this case, you can see me using a little doohickey, and it's actually just a little bottle that's about 1.25 inches in diameter, and it worked perfectly to use as a radius for fairing on the swim platform and in between the transom and the motor well.
So I am going to put this Flexisander through its paces tonight. What I've done is I picked up a rubber fern coat from the local plumbing shop right here, reducer fern coat. And I've hooked it to my vacuum attachment, so I'll be able to actually hook my vacuum directly into the back of this. All right, so it sits just like so. And again, we are on running European power here. This is a 250 volt, I think it's 50 hertz plug. So we do have the inverter over here and a little bit of setup here, but I think we're getting everything going. So tonight we're gonna give it a full test with suction, with vacuum suction. And again, I have the Abernet screen on here, so hopefully all that that works out pretty well for us. And yeah, so I'm gonna put it through the paces, throw you guys in time lapse, try to hit this pretty hard tonight. So all right, thanks for watching. Alright guys, so I figured I'd give you my honest opinion on this Flexisander here. I'm just gonna make this quick because my battery's almost dead on my camera, but Flexisander. It works well for the most part. I do find that it's on its own, probably not everything you need. I have been switching back and forth between the Flexisander and the DuraBlock sanding blocks, and I'm making some pretty good headway. We're about half of this haul done here, give or take, right around the sander is just past that over here, down and all the way back, and I've also come across here on the back side. But I'm into it for about 2 hours right now. Yeah, there's Cassie coming to tell me to wrap up and get the hell inside. Stop making noise. It's definitely taking a lot of the grunt work out of it, which is nice. But again, by itself, it's not everything you need. You definitely need to do some longboarding with it. So as of right now, for the investment, I mean, it's a little pricey of a product, but seems to be worth it so far. So we'll definitely keep you up to date if we should find any other findings on it, and go from there. Thank you. so.
Bird.
Yeah. Bird. No. Can you open the front door, hon?
Oh, it's not. Oh, he just went out.
Okay, cool.
Hold on, I gotta put the thing back.
You put the camera back. I was trying to get the bird on camera. That's the little guy that keeps pooping on our boat.